The James Webb Space Telescope is the premier telescope of the next decade. Webb was successfully launched on December 25, 2021, and has already revealed many wonders of the universe, including a new image released October 2022, which we'll cover later in this video. Join us as we look at some amazing images from the James Webb Space Telescope. Before we get to the amazing photos coming up, let's learn a little bit about what allows James Webb to capture such stunning images. The largest part of Webb is its five-layer sun shield, the size of a tennis court. This sun shield reduces heat from the sun by more than a million times. The sun shield is important because most of Webb's data comes from infrared light, which is essentially heat energy, and excess heat could throw off Webb's ability to capture faint infrared signals. James Webb's primary mirror is made up of 18 separate segments, giving it a honeycomb look. There are four capturing instruments: the Near Infrared Camera, or NIRCam, the Near Infrared Spectrograph, or NIRSpec, the Mid-Infrared Instrument, or MIRI, and the Fine Guidance Sensor, / Near-Infrared Imager and Slitless Spectrograph, or FGS NIRIS. NIRCam. The Near-Infrared Camera is James Webb's primary imager. It covers the near-infrared range of the electromagnetic spectrum from 0.6 to 5 microns. NIRCam is equipped with coronagraphs, instruments that allow for the imaging of faint objects near a bright object. NIRCam's coronagraphs work by blocking out the brighter object's light, allowing for the dimmer object to be seen. These coronagraphs will help astronomers determine characteristics of exoplanets orbiting stars. NIRCam will detect light from the earliest stars and galaxies, stars in nearby galaxies, young stars in the Milky Way, and objects in the Kuiper Belt, the ring of objects surrounding our solar system out past Pluto. NIRSpec. The near-infrared spectrometer will operate in the same wavelength range, 0.6 to 5 microns, as the NIRCam. Spectrographs observe light from an object and disperse it into a spectrum, similar to how a white light shown through a prism reveals a rainbow on the other side. Scientists can analyze this spectrum to determine many physical properties of the object, such as temperature, chemical composition, and even mass. A spectrum can be thought of like the object's fingerprint. MIRI. The mid-infrared instrument is comprised of both a camera and spectrograph. Being a mid-infrared device, this instrument focuses on the wavelength range from 5 to 28 microns. These wavelengths are not visible to the human eye. MIRI will allow us to see newly forming stars, distant galaxies, objects in the Kuiper Belt, and very faint comets. FGS NIRIS. The Fine Guidance Sensor is what allows James Webb to point precisely at an object and obtain high-quality images. The Near-Infrared Imager and Slitless Spectrograph will investigate the first light after the Big Bang. Spectroscopy of exoplanets as they transit in front of their stars, and the detection and characterization of exoplanets. NIRIS operates over the wavelength range of 0.8 to 5 microns. James Webb's amazing images so far. Stefan's Quintet. This is the largest image so far by James Webb. It covers a space that is the size of 1/5 of the moon's diameter. It was captured by both NIRCam and MIRI. Stefan's Quintet is a group of five galaxies. With the powerful resolution of Webb, we are able to see details we have never seen before. We can now see clusters of young stars and starburst regions of new star birth. The gravitational interactions between these galaxies pull dust and gas from each other, which we can now see as tails trailing from some of the galaxies. The most dramatic thing we can see in this image is shock waves being emitted as one of the galaxies smashes through the cluster. These shock waves are the red and gold streaks between galaxies. Stefan's quintet is important to astronomers studying galaxy evolution. A key part of galaxy evolution is the interactions and merging of galaxies. Webb has provided details of interacting galaxies rarely seen before, allowing astronomers to use Stefan's quintet as a laboratory to study these processes. These new insights will provide valuable insights into how galaxy evolution may have been driven by galactic interactions in the early universe. Tarantula Nebula. The Tarantula Nebula is a star-forming region spanning 340 light-years across. The James Webb's NIRCam captured this image and revealed thousands of young stars never seen before. These stars are covered in dust and were previously undetectable until NIRCam. The pale blue region is the most actively forming stars. Exploring this image, we see an older star to the upper left of the pale blue star-forming region. This star appears to have spikes, an artifact of the telescope. If you follow the top spike upward, you can see a small bubble. This bubble is caused by young stars blowing out dusty material. The rusty color of the outer regions of the nebula tells astronomers that there are large amounts of hydrocarbons in the Tarantula Nebula. James Webb is allowing us to study this stellar nursery in greater detail than ever before. Southern Ring Nebula. Webb's NIRCam image of the Southern Ring Nebula has revealed many layers of detail. At the center of this nebula is a bright star, but this star is not the nebula's source. The nebula's source is a star that is now barely visible at the bottom left of the bright star's diffraction spikes. This origin star ejected at least 8 layers of gas and dust over thousands of years. The central bright star has changed the shape of the nebula's rings by creating turbulence. The jaggedness of the rings is caused by the two stars orbiting each other. As the origin star orbits, it emits gas and dust in a variety of directions. If you look closely, you can see hundreds of brightly lit lines shooting through the rings of the nebula. These come from the bright star and stream through holes in the nebula, like sunlight streaming through clouds. Cartwheel Galaxy. This image is a composite image from both NIRCam and MIRI. It depicts the Cartwheel Galaxy and its companion galaxies. By creating a composite image, we can see details that would be hard to see in the individual images. MIRI data is colored red, and NIRCam data is given colors blue, orange, and yellow. Approximately 400 million years ago, there was a high-speed collision that resulted in the formation of the Cartwheel Galaxy. There are two rings, a bright inner ring and a colorful outer ring. These rings expand outward from the collision like shock waves. Even though this was a massive collision, there are many features of the original spiral galaxy remaining. The old spiral galaxy's rotating arms are seen in the spokes of the cartwheel. This image will allow astronomers to study both galaxy evolution and star formation in great detail. Cosmic cliffs in the Carina Nebula. These cosmic cliffs are a star-forming region at the edge of the Carina Nebula. James Webb's NIRCam reveals areas of starbirth that were previously obscured. These cliffs are at the edge of a giant gas cavity in the NGC 3324 star-forming region of the Carina Nebula. This giant cavity was carved out of the nebula from the radiation and solar winds of newly formed stars in the center of the bubble, shown in the top half of the image. There are key features seen in this image. There appears to be steam rising from the mountains. This is hot, ionized gas. Pillars rise up against the glowing wall of gas, resisting the radiation from the young stars. Radiation from newly formed stars blow bubbles in cavities in the surrounding dust. It is hard to capture this period of star formation in a star's life. For one star, it only lasts 50,000 to 100,000 years. James Webb's sensitivity and resolution have allowed us to capture this spectacular event. Pillars of Creation. Both MIRI and NIRCam captured the pillars of creation. With NIRCam, we see a range of bright colors. Newly forming stars can be seen in the knots in the pillars as red orbs. Around the edges of the pillars, there are wavy lines that resemble lava. These are ejections from stars that are still forming. MIRI's images, released in October 2022, however, gives these pillars a more sinister view. We no longer view the thousands of stars, and instead see thick layers of gas and dust. The reason we don't see many stars in the MIRI image is because stars usually don't give off much mid-infrared light, instead emitting ultraviolet, visible, and near-infrared light, while dust shines most brightly in the mid-infrared. Dust is a key ingredient for star formation and is very important for us to study. Both of the MIRI and NIRCam images allow astronomers to study star formation like never before. The James Webb Space Telescope is the defining telescope of this generation. Like Hubble, James Webb will provide us with not only beautiful images, but also reveal hidden secrets of our universe. Tell us which image from the James Webb is your favorite so far in the comments below, and let us know if you have any suggestions or feedback for us. We appreciate your input. Thanks for watching, and take a moment to check out this next video, which you might find intriguing.